Yes, indeed. So tight, huh? I mean, that's just like listening to listening to the band itself. Instructors, dynamite. Let's give a hand for Mr. Curtis Abbey. Okay, and we move along. After Yardbird Suite, for all of you up-and-coming musicians, this is what Charlie Parker once said. He said, you've got to learn, then you practice, practice, and practice. I guess what you would say, woochie, you know? You've got to learn your instrument. Then you practice, practice, and practice. And then when you finally get up there on the bandstand, forget all that and just wail. Charlie was known to have practiced up to 15 hours a day. He worked as a dishwasher in a restaurant making $9 a week just to learn from listening to the great jazz pianist Art Tatum. He'd go where Art was and he'd sit down and he'd just listen. When Parker was too young to be in clubs, he was always found outside the clubs listening to the bands on the inside. For him, this is practicing. And now, under the direction of Alison Stewart, we'll hear some poetry that was transformed and revised after listening to some jazz tracks. We present the creative writing class. Let's listen to their creativity. Let's give them a hand as they come up.
Hello. All right. My poem is called The Bard, and it was inspired by a night in Tunisia. All right, so here it is. There was a bard who stayed up late sampling some foreign opiate, who dreamt of silver clouds and golden shining sand drifting through his hands. He sang, although he was turning blue, and there was rhythm to his rhyme. It was madness, kept in time. And his word was like a dart that traveled the invisible through and gave Iolani's art a world of sound on a silver plate touching on some innate theme. A fair garden through a metal gate, or maybe a vision in a dream. He was thusly inspired, and then he expired. Thank you.
Hi, this piece was inspired by A Night in Tunisia by Charlie Parker and Dizzy Gillespie. It's called Vine Jazz. The vines are creeping steadily, mundane and inching forward, slow. They whisper gently to themselves, the dreary stillness weighs them down. At dawn, the rays of sun caress their tendrils, pale and stiff with cold, so they soften. Revitalized in a burst of energy, they grow, reaching their long, spindly fingers to the light above. They surge forward, spinning in spirals, twisting together. The convoluted mass drives in jubilation to celebrate the new day.
The lilting, trilling, never-filling sound. If meaning wants a chance of showing, the melodies will keep on snowing until the cold numbs stiff hands. Keep snowing melodies so that I may sleep under a blanket of white to hide from the dark colorless sky and protect my sorry hands from the waste of absence.
Hi, this is inspired by A Night in Tunisia. It's called All That Jazz, Just Cuz. Hopping off that plane, getting in that little cab, speeding through traffic, finally making it into the club, surprisingly in perfect syncopation. We trip into the club, backstage, clouded with smoke, the lights are flickering, I think the roof is leaking, a menagerie of chaos. My sax is flat, the bass is sharp, the trumpets are dented, and the piano can't play C. A storm of perfect beats. But through all that junk, the time crunch, the setup, instruments, we still got that one thing, all that jazz.
I'm Ali Storito, and those are some of my amazing students. So I decided to do this because I had to really convince them. So here it is, making sense of it all. Bullets released to fly in all directions, cover my ears to dampen the blows, and now I can hear the connections. I catch the drift, and the rift drags me to acceleration, bebop, and my knee won't stop bouncing. Toe tapping, head bobbing, all is in motion, and we swing. Baseline cuts rough waters, dive to cool depths, current's powers appeased. At ease, let go and fall and rise and twirl. Release, muscles unclench, led to the place I'm supposed to be. Thank you.
All that creativity, huh? I had the pleasure, along with Elliot Maker, we went into the classrooms. Elliot went into the band classrooms and gave a lecture on Miles Davis and Kind of Blue. And I gave a lecture to the African American history class, which I had no idea they had one here. And before I continue, I'd like to thank Stephen Stack, Emma Ching, Stephen Toyofuka, and Hanul Seo. I hope I pronounced that right. Let's give them a hand one more time. And now, we step into the hard bop and cool jazz era with trumpet great Miles Davis. Miles played with both Charlie Parker and Dizzy Gillespie. To examine his career is to examine the history of jazz from the mid-40s to the early 90s, since he was in the thick of almost every important innovation and stylistic development in the music during that period. And he often led the way in those changes, both with his own performances and recordings, and by choosing sidemen and collaborators who forged new directions. It can be argued that jazz stopped evolving when Miles wasn't there to push it forward. From his album, Kind of Blue, which on October the 7th, 2008, was certified quadruple platinum sales in sales by the Recording Association of America, and also celebrated its 50th anniversary year on August 2008. We hear All Blues, played by the Stage Band 3 and performed in dance by Iolani's Dance 4 class under the direction of Cyrene Okimura.